What's up, members of the committee? So, I watched the GameStop Congressional hearing the other day. Apparently, I had nothing better to do for 5.5 hours, but while I was watching, I noticed a few things that I haven't seen anyone else talking about. We'll start with some jokes, but maybe we'll get a little serious at the end if you're not in the mood for a hearty chuckle. Let's let Chairwoman Waters kick it off.
This hearing is entitled, GameStop: Who Wins and Loses When Short Sellers, Social Media, and Retail Investors Collide.
First things first, the name needs some serious work. I'm not saying the name has to be one word like it's everyone's favorite rapper, but I think we could trim it down a bit. Also, the question mark went on vacation and I don't like where it landed. It shouldn't be GameStop. It should be GameStop. Who wins and loses when short sellers, social media, and retail investors collide? Anyway, let's introduce our cast of characters. We've already met Maxine Waters, so let's move on to Brad Sherman, who's sitting so close to his bookshelf that it looks like he's part of it. It reminds me of that part of the crew, part of the ship scene from Pirates of the Caribbean.
Part of the crew, part of the ship. Part of the crew, part of the ship. Part of the crew, part
Steady
of the
man.
Ship.
Part of the crew, part of the
bookshelf.
Also, a little more proof that he's merging with the shelf is that little bottle in the top right. It might look like an ordinary bottle of lotion, but I have a sneaking suspicion that he turned it away from the camera to hide the fact that it's actually a 2-in-1 combination of moisturizer and wood varnish. Next up, we have the co-founder and CEO of Robinhood, Vlad Tenev, aka the less fun version of Spencer from iCarly. I don't have much to say about him, other than that he really likes thanking people for their questions. Also, his name backwards is Venet Dalve, which roughly translates to Spank Me Daddy in a language I just made up. Moving forward, we have Kenneth Griffin, founder and CEO of Citadel LLC. I just wanted to point out that his setup looks like he's trying to film a one-man remake of Between Two Ferns, but accidentally doubled his plant order. Also, he does this little flourish when he raises his hand to be sworn in that made me laugh out loud when I first saw it.
Do you solemnly swear?
Class, sass, and possibly ass. He's got it all. Next is Gabriel Plotkin, the CEO of Melvin Capital, who takes interior design lessons from an abandoned Office Depot. I'm going to play you a short clip of him, and I want to see if you notice what I noticed.
I'm the founder and chief investment officer of Melvin Capital.
Did you see it? Just in case, I'll play it again in slow motion and boost the audio levels. Keep an eye on his mouth.
I'm the founder and chief investment officer of Melvin Capital.
Yummy.
Steve Huffman, the co-founder and CEO of Reddit, also stopped by. I don't have any jokes about him, but I would like to remind him to make sure that Brad Sherman doesn't get anywhere near that bookshelf. Also, I paused the video at one point and accidentally caught him cosplaying as a drunk guy trying to whistle. Next is Keith Gill, aka Roaring Kitty, aka DFV. I've got nothing but respect for him, so I'll let him tell you a bit about himself.
A few things I am not. I am not a cat. I am not an institutional investor, nor am I a hedge fund. As for me, I like the stock.
Jennifer Shulp, the director of financial regulation studies, also participated in the hearing. She was really helpful throughout the hearing, so I don't want to make fun of her, but I do want to congratulate her on receiving an award for the world's highest window-to-wall ratio. Also, I was playing a sped-up version of the hearing and noticed that the sirens in the background of this clip make it sound like she's trying to hurry up and finish before she gets arrested.
Most point to zero commission trading, but several other factors also likely attracted retail investors, including fractional share trading, low account minimums, and easy app-based platforms. More time at home during the pandemic probably even played a role.
Continuing on the topic of awards and accomplishments, I'd like to congratulate Representative Frank Lucas on his recent achievement of recreating Bigfoot's blurry cloaking technology. It's like I always say, if it's blurry, it's probably Bigfoot. Unless, of course, it's Representative Frank Lucas, in which case it's just the representative of Oklahoma's 3rd District. No need to panic. Another award I'd like to discuss is the one I'll be giving to Representative Ann Wagner, who managed to be the only person in the hearing who rocked two different haircuts at the same time. She's gone for David Bowie in the front, middle school secretary in the back. It doesn't roll off the tongue quite as easily as business in the front, party in the back, but she's paid to represent, not to name things. Although that would explain the abhorrent name of this hearing. The final award I'd like to give before moving on goes to Representative John Rose for his abstract art piece, Squiggle Light. If you take a look at his light, you'll notice a wave that goes across it, and I have no idea what's causing it. You might think it's a computer glitch, but as you'll see in this sped-up clip, it doesn't move at all. Mr. Rose is truly a pioneer of the deformed light fixture art scene. Speaking of art, let's take a closer look at some of the artwork in the backgrounds. We'll start with this one that made me say to myself, there's no way that's a couple of people made out of a bunch of pieces of melon. And then, upon further inspection, realize that it is in fact a couple of people made out of a bunch of pieces of melon. Next up, we have a gorgeous painting of a tropical sunset. Although, now that I'm looking at it again, it also kind of looks like a colorized photo of what it would have looked like right after the nuclear bomb went off at Bikini Atoll. Coming in with two pieces of art is Mr. Sean Kasten, who's chosen a tasteful pairing of Van Gogh's Starry Night and an American flag that appears to be suffering from a rare genetic disorder. You can see him looking at it. He knows I'm right. The last piece of art I want to look at is this piece that belongs to Mr. David Kustoff. This artwork tells me three things about Mr. Kustoff. He's never seen a bridge in real life, he loves the color blue, and he got the Crayola 64-pack for Christmas. Although, he's doing better than Mr. Hollingsworth, who looks like he just finished setting up Mr. Plotkin's new office. Before getting into the more serious section of the video, I'd like to show you just how many times some of the representatives said game stock instead of game stop.
Game stock.
Game stock. Game stock. Stock.
Game stock.
Game stock.
Game stock. Game stock. Game stock. Game stock.
I'd also like to show you evidence that watching this 5.5-hour hearing didn't mature me at all, because I've watched this clip 300 times and I smile every single time.
Were you in a naked position in your short position?
All right, it's time to get a little more serious. First of all, if you thought any part of this video was funny, please hit the subscribe button. It's free, it helps the channel grow, and you won't miss an opportunity to hear me ramble about artwork and hairstyles. Second, I want to recommend that anyone who made it this far should watch the whole hearing or read the transcript, both of which are linked in the description. If it's too long, I get it, but at least watch part of it or watch a highlight video. There are a lot of moments that I thought were incredibly important for everyone to hear. It's clear to everyone that Keith Gill and other retail investors aren't the bad guys here. If I'm being honest, I don't think Vlad and Robin Hood are the bad guys either. I'd go so far as to say that even Melvin Capital and Citadel aren't the bad guys, at least not entirely. Even though what they did and continue to do is extremely unethical, this hearing showed us that that doesn't matter. They're allowed to get away with whatever they want because they donate to many of the campaigns of the representatives at this hearing. I'm not exactly breaking new ground by pointing out that politicians are bought and paid for, but watching this hearing made that fact clearer to me than ever before. Throughout the 5.5-hour hearing, I don't think I heard a single representative bring up the fact that regulations are already in place to keep hedge funds from creating the situation that they're in now. The majority of the questions they asked focused on the possibility of putting new regulations in place to keep people like you and me from participating in the markets on an even playing field. Keep in mind that the people making these suggestions are the same people who know so little about what's going on that they can't be bothered to get the name of the company right. These are the people who have direct access to the person who started this movement, yet only 5 of them spoke directly to him throughout the hearing. These are people who don't trust you, who don't believe that you're smart enough to make financial decisions or do your own research. They think they have to protect you from yourself, and that's the best case scenario. Worst case scenario, these people are scared. They saw a potential transfer of wealth away from the people that fund them, and their first thought was to regulate away our ability to make decisions for ourselves. If you do decide to watch the hearing, look out for a few key things. Pay attention to which of these representatives casually suggest that more power be taken away from the people through government regulation. Notice how few of those same people made any mention of increasing regulations on hedge funds, let alone actually enforcing the regulations that are already in place. Pay attention to the way they ask non-yes or no questions and then demand a yes or no answer to appear tough. Pay attention to the way they refuse to let the witnesses finish their answers by talking over them or yielding their time. Pay attention to the way they suggest ideas like a financial transaction tax, hear an expert tell them that it's not a good idea and that it will hurt people like you and me, and then continue to suggest it. Watch for the ways they ignore conflicting information and then shut down the people that are providing it. This is not a political statement, but please keep this hearing in mind the next time you vote. At the end of the day, late January was set to be one of the largest, if not the largest, transfer of wealth from the ultra-wealthy to the average person, and it was shadily halted before it could happen. However, there was no talk during this hearing of repercussions that the hedge funds should have to face for this. The main focus for many of these representatives was preventing the people from being able to play at the same level as the hedge funds and to do what they want with their money. Please don't forget that. Thanks for watching.